Time to know.
Throw
the court and high. Feet. Soup has always been a popular item all over the world because vegetables were cultivated by many and were cheap and easy to come by. Rumor has it that the King of France, Louis XV, created this recipe with whatever he had at hand in his hunting pavilion in Versailles. He used onions, butter, and champagne instead of water, though. Now, another story is that the Stanislaus Leszczynski, King of Poland, while visiting France, stopped at an inn where a famous French cook named Nicolas Appert was officiating. He tasted the soup and found it so delectable that he would not leave the inn without the recipe. Nicolas was happy to oblige, and the Stanislaus soup was officially born. The king was happy to show off his skills and cook the soup for his son-in-law, Louis XV, King of France. It was quickly adopted by the king's entourage. One thing for sure, it was during the Louis XV reign that the recipe got popular. The capacity of the soup to mask the smell of the alcohol made it the number one item on the list to cure hangover. So in some regions of France, it was called the drunkard soup, and it can be served after a long meal to sober the guests. In some regions, like the Alps or the Pyrenees, the shepherds or herdsmen would eat the soup all the time because it requires very little supplies, and they could use the cheese they produced up in the mountains.
So, do you know how do you prepare a French onion soup? What do you need?
Tears.
Not yet. No, it's a very simple recipe. You just need onions, water, a little bit of cheese at the end. And it's a very traditional soup, very simple and delicious. So first, what do you have to do?
Well, first you have to chop up the onions.
Okay.
And then, I mean, you have to peel them first, obviously.
Yes. And you do not?
Okay, I don't know how to peel onions.
Yes, so first you peel the onion.
Is that good?
Take the small knife.
Okay.
Can I show you?
Yes, please.
You are lucky because you have glasses, so maybe you won't cry.
No, last time we used onions, I did cry.
Okay.
Because of Drake.
Yes, it's true. Yes.
Wow, I'm really bad at this.
Do you know you can perhaps take care of the butter?
Here's some.
Sorry.
When you're ready.
Oh, that burns.
Are you back on track?
Yeah, I was like, okay. Oh, yeah, my glasses.
Yeah. Would you melt the butter in the pan over there?
Yeah, that one there.
Wait, just drop it in?
No, no, it's dripping.
I think it's all good.
Cool.
Salt and pepper?
How much? All of it?
Of course.
Yeah. Really?
Of course not.
Oh, okay. So then how much?
Like, I have been looking like this. And same for the pepper. Top. And after you can adjust at the end. You test
uh-huh.
it and you'll see. Okay, now you can wait during 10-15 minutes. And during this time, you have to work on the cheese.
So dinner, are you ready
yes.
to grate the cheese?
Yes, I am.
So be careful, remember, with your fingers.
Yes, don't kill my fingers.
Exactly.
Yes.
Like, which one, which side should I
that
use?
One
There's
one
so
one.
Many options.
Yeah. Careful. Be careful. Okay, so during that time, we will prepare the bread. Okay, so we will, you will cut the bread. I will give you a
how many pieces.
So we need some pieces of bread to go on top. So we'll serve the soup in those. Okay, and then on top of it we will put a piece of bread with some and first we have to before to cut it.
Still grating the cheese. Don't worry. Haven't stopped.
And that
yeah.
We will be us the bread. And this time the soup is bubbling. Let me see, maybe it's enough.
But
yes, I think it's enough. But you can finish this part.
Can I eat this?
Yeah. Okay. No, no. Maybe cut it. No, directly in your mouth. Okay. Directly. Voilà.
Interesting cheese.
But it's I think it's is this the piece of it? I think it's Gruyère.
Oh.
It's Gruyère or Comté. Gruyère.
I think it's Gruyère. But I don't think. Gruyère, Comté, Emmental, all of those cheese from Europe? No.
Yes.
Yes. You agree?
Uh-huh.
Perfect. That's good, that's probably good. It's ready.
That's good.
So what about the bread? So now we can test. And for you. Not ready yet.
Yeah.
But it's very close.
Okay.
Yes. No, it doesn't
okay,
matter.
So the
this
soup is ready.
Who wants to cut the bread?
Me.
You do that?
I want to cut the bread.
Cut
okay.
the bread.
Oh, yeah! I get bread.
So you can pour the soup.
Yes.
Yes. If you don't mind.
No, no.
Okay, so I'll come with the soup.
And
cut.
Okay, so you pour the sauce.
Yes.
And be careful how much.
Very warm.
Okay.
And then if you like paper, you can add a bit of paper at the end. So the oven is ready.
Yes.
Bread tower.
If you want.
Yes.
I think it's enough. We are enough. Now, this is a smaller piece.
Mm-hmm.
There's one. And pour some cheese on the top.
Cheese.
Sure, thank you.
Oops.
Some for this one.
Yeah.
And some for...
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, this one too. Something. Oh, that wasn't good. Some for this one. Any others, or is that? Just
I think we need nine.
Nine. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Some for this one. Some for this one. That's 8. And some for this one.
And you can add some cheese.
And some for.
And then last one.
Oh.
That's supposed to be delicious.
Voila. Good. Now.
And some for me.
Okay, so now you can add the bread on the top. So it's a nice appetizer. It could be also a main dish if you have a bigger bowl. Whatever you like.
In the oven? In the oven.
Okay.
4 or 5 minutes. It depends on the oven.
Oh, you caught me here just ordering.
Yes.
Yes.
Want to see?
Whoa.
This is ready. You have to try with the bread and the cheese.
Oh, try the bread and cheese.
Be careful, it could be hot. It's hot.
I'd say this is pretty good.
Ah, and Ines?
Delicious. Really
what do you
good.
Think for your first edition?
It was a very good experience. Oh. I hope to do this again.
Yes, we also. Thank you very much too. And thank you, Dina.
No problem. I'm always here. Every month, just pop up out of nowhere. Nothing you can do about it. Sorry.
So thank you very much. See you next time.
Bye.